Salut! Here's a way you can both practice your French and gain motivation to learn even more. Watch great French comedies. I know that you probably already know about some flagship movies such as Intouchables or Amélie. That's why today I want to talk about some older, weirder movies. They're funny, they're original, and they can give you another way to practice your French that's not in your usual textbooks. Which movies? How can you find them? And which famous lines can you use with French people as a quick cultural reference? You will find more details in the full written lesson, including quotes, cultural commentaries, and random things I wanted to add. Go to comeinfrancaise.com and on the blog below the video, you will find everything you need. You will find a link in the description if you're watching that on YouTube. Bonjour, I'm Géraldine, bienvenue sur Comme une Française TV. Allez, c'est parti! La classe américaine, also called le grand détournement, le grand détournement, is a 1993 television film. La classe means style in French. For example, wow, Julie, tes nouvelles chaussures à perroquet, c'est la classe. Wow, Julie! Tes nouvelles chaussures à perroquet, c'est la classe. Wow, Julie, your new shoes with parrots on them, they're very stylish. In older slang, la classe américaine is great, great style. Un détournement is an artistic remake of previous works such as movies or advertisement. And this movie is nothing but un détournement. Indeed. It's made out of clips from older American movies such as Citizen Kane and All the President's Men or Western films with John Wayne, but redubbed with new French dialogues to create a completely new absurd storyline. Two journalists try to find Georges Habitbol, played by John Wayne, as l'homme le plus classe du monde. L'homme le plus classe du monde, the classiest man on earth. La classe américaine was made by French director Michel Hazanavicius. Michel Hazanavicius, who later directed the great movie The Artist. Yes, that was him. As well as the two great, great, great French comedies, OSS 117, that I always recommend because I love them. Les vacances de Monsieur Hulot. Les vacances de Monsieur Hulot. Mr. Hulot's Holidays is the 1953 movie by visionary French actor and director Jacques Tati. I love this movie and this is one of my dad's favorites, so he passed this on to me. The naive, lovable character of Monsieur Hulot is trying out this new fad, summer holidays at the beach. That's completely new.
Hein? Comment? Permettez. Hulot.
The movie shows us a wide range of French characters and gently mocks the small absurdities of modern life. It's a very sweet and funny movie and it aged pretty well. Jacques Tati loves to show the simple French way of life at the time, as well as the failings of complex technology over simple pleasure. He did it again in his later movies such as Playtime, which I can't recommend enough, it's wonderful. La folie des grandeurs, la Folie des Grandeurs, The Legends of Grandeur in French, is a 1971 French comedy directed by Gérard Houry. Gérard Houry. Houry is also famous for other great comedies, especially La Grande Vadrouille. La Grande Vadrouille, The Great Stroll, which is one of the most famous French comedies of all time. Lots of people watch it every year around Christmas. I will always recommend this one as well. Just like La Grande Vadrouille, La Folie des Grandeurs stars French comedian Louis de Funès. Louis de Funès. De Funès was an amazing French physical actor and a hallmark of the 60s and 70s French comedy. He holds a giant place in French humor. You have to know him. The second protagonist is played by French actor and famous singer Yves Montand, with his smooth, very sexy voice. La Folie des Grandeurs is a loose adaptation of Ruy Blas, a play by famous French author Victor Hugo. The movie is set at the 17th century Spanish court. Louis de Funès is a greedy tax collector who falls out of grace. He tries to get his job back through plotting and manipulation with the help of his valet, Yves Montand. Yes. One scene is especially famous. You will find more about it on the full written lesson on the blog. Yes, all is in there. To go the extra mile, you can also check out Les Aventures de Rabbi Jacob. Les Aventures de Rabbi Jacob, another great, great movie by Gérard Houry, starring Louis de Funès as well. 2 heures moins le quart avant Jésus-Christ. 2 heures moins le quart avant Jésus-Christ. A quarter to two before Christ. It's a parody of peplum movies such as Ben-Hur. Yes, that's how we say it in French. Ben-Hur, filled with des anachronismes. It's anachronistic gags. The movie came out in 1982. It was directed by French actor, director and writer Jean Yann, starring the great comedy actor Michel Serrault as Caesar and the very famous comedian Coluche. He plays the protagonist called Ben-Hur Marcel that gets involved by mistake in a plot against the French emperor. It's a funny cult movie related to the Asterix comic books La Bande Dessinée, which also depicts an alternative Roman Empire for comedic purposes. A good mix between the movie 2 heures moins le quart avant Jésus-Christ and the comic books Asterix is the 2002 movie adaptation of Astérix et Obélix, Mission Cléopâtre is the best, funniest movie version of Asterix, and I always recommend it. La Cité de la Peur. Well, it's a bit funny to talk about this because it's one of my favorite movies from my childhood, but it's still from 1994. So it's an older comedy movie. It was directed by Alain Berberian and written by the comedy group Les Nuls. Along with the other comedy trio Les Inconnus, Les Nuls defined French humor of the 80s and 90s. The movie is set during le Festival de Cannes, the Cannes Festival, between a serial killer on the loose and a marketing agent trying to use his murders to promote the new movie. There's a gag a minute and all the dialogue got quoted endlessly throughout the 90s. Use them to make fast friends with French people. You can also treat yourself to a funny evening by watching these comedies in French if you dare. I highly recommend you turn on subtitles in French because it can be a bit difficult to understand. Et toi, what other older comedies do you enjoy? Tell me in French if you dare in the comment section on the blog. It's a perfect opportunity for you to practice and I would love to hear from you. If you're on YouTube, you can find a link below this video to the episode on commeunefrancaise.com where you can write directly to me. I read all the comments on there and answer all your questions as well. You can get more explanation and detailed conversation scripts in my Everyday French Crash Course. You can subscribe right now, it's free and easy to join. You just have to click on the link below. It's a 10-day mini course to sound French, even to the French. Just leave me your first name, your email, and you will receive lesson one immediately. Best of all, it's free. Merci for watching Comme une Française TV, sound French, even to the French. Allez, salut!